same when I'm away from you. Do you know the line that I'd walk for you? We could turn around or we could give it up, but we'll take what comes, take what comes. Oh, the storm is raging against us now. If you're afraid of falling, then don't look down. But we took the step, but we took the leap, and we'll take what comes, take what comes. Feel the wind in your hair, feel the rush way up here. We're walking the wild.
Guys didn't have the best starts to your seasons, but here we are standing here and you guys are still going back to state.
Sorry.
Okay, so the first, like over the summer, I felt like really tired and stuff, but I just thought it was because I was training really hard. And then like my first couple races weren't as good as like I had hoped they would be or like expected them to be. So Eric suggested that I get my ferritin and my iron levels tested. And my ferritin was like, 16? And it was supposed to be like 60. So yeah, I had to like start taking supplements and like eating a lot of spinach. And yeah, it gradually improved and now I'm back in the normal range.
So. Oh gosh, the season started out completely terrible. You know, my attitude wasn't helping it at all. You know, I did not imagine I was going to state this season at all. If you told me at the beginning of the season I'd be going to state, I would have said you're lying and you're full of crap. I believe my head got in the game on the Oregon trip. Honestly, these group of girls are so special and I love them so much.
In my mind, like, this was our most successful season because, like, when we first set the goal of going to state at the beginning of the year, I was kind of like, okay, really? Like, are we going to just keep saying, like, okay, we're going to make it, and then not making it? But, like, this year I felt like everyone truly, like, believed in it, and, like, we said this was our 1 out of 10 day, and I feel like we really gave it our all. So I'm just proud that, like, we could have ended on a note where everyone, like, believed in us and believed in it, that we'd be successful. Thank you guys for working so hard and for letting me believe that this was our year. And I'm so glad that our race together, like my last race with you guys, could be this one with all six of you. So yeah, I love you guys.
See, I can't beat that, so me too. I'm not sentimental, like I'm just...
Wait, we didn't do it.
Oh.
Magic in the air.
be like, ooh, so bad. Ooh. Everywhere I go, they be like, ooh, so bad. Ooh. Everywhere I go, they be like, ooh, so bad. Nah, 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 watch me break it down like, 24 karat, 24 karat magic. What's that sound? Just put your pinky rings up to the moon. Girls, what y'all trying to do? Tell me what you're trying to do.
We're all from different backgrounds and we have all different grades involved in the sport, and that we are able to come together almost like we're friends and family.
We have that family atmosphere. I like that I can let go of everything in my day and just be happy and cross-country. I like that my teammates, I've turned it to my family, the Unity people, the Oregon trip. It felt so amazing to be with the people that cares about running as much as you do. Like, you can't get that anymore.
A bunch of new people, you know, see a bunch of new personalities, and just be around something I liked with people I liked better.
The camaraderie between everyone, you know, get better at sports. Like, remember from the basketball first play, you know, like we're like brothers too, but it's not the same.
Just like the atmosphere, it's like you can't find it anywhere else.
Well, I think obviously I like running, you know, and I like the competition that we have and our races, like competing with other people. And the one thing I really like is like the team atmosphere. Like, I feel like we're all really close and we all like got to know each other a lot, even though it was just like a short amount of time. And like, then like the friendships that I've made, like, are really like some of my best friendships that I have.
Are the friendships you make along the way and the amazing people that I've met over the last 4 years, and how running teaches you about determination and goal setting when you try to reach those running goals.
It's like the friendships and the bonds that you make with other people that, like, I don't know, you necessarily wouldn't like become friends with on campus because of, like, friend groups. Like, I mean, you meet new people and it's a pretty fun experience.
I definitely like the people the most and the environment they make.
The amount of effort and work you put into the sport is exactly what you get out of it. So the more work and effort you put into the cross country, the more you'll get out of it.
I feel like we use injuries as an excuse not to do anything. And don't do nothing. Like, don't do anything. Just like, do something. Like, get up. Like, even if you can't move, like if it's your hip, like you can't go out, you can't work out, then make your mind strong. You always have room to improve something. You can make anything better for when you come back. I don't know if that makes sense, but it doesn't. You know what I'm saying? Like, you shouldn't just be doing nothing. If you really care about the sport, you'll do something to make yourself better. You'll make it.
Try to make relationships with, like, as many people as you can on the team, because then when you get closer with them, it, like, makes you want to run for each other more.
Go to everything and listen to your elders, whether it's the elders on your team or the coaches or your parents, just, you know, and be respectful.
To have fun and work hard and the results will follow. Like, if you like what you do, if you enjoy what you're doing, then you're gonna improve and you're gonna get better.
We need to keep going, even when it gets tough, like even a rough race or a rough week or even a rough season. Like, it's not the end of the world, it's not definitive. Like, you can keep going and you could bounce back from that.
Stay hydrated and work hard during practices.
Like, take in every moment. Like me, I miss a lot of meets and I really regret that because, like, I do enjoy the sport. And so, like, I would just try to make every meet, try to get to practice, like, every practice, and just do your best because that's all you can do. Oh, work hard.
Yeah. Is that you have to push through boundaries because there's definitely going to be physical and mental boundaries, and as soon as you get past them and like they're behind you, then it's a lot more like easier to like run, and like you just feel like you have more ability.
Almost being like a second family, almost that. Coming here, being accepted automatically, little to no drama, that's what wellness was, that's sport.
I'm gonna miss just like everybody on the team and like how close we are. Like, we're literally friends to family, and I don't know, it's just the experience of all 4 years.
The competitiveness of the sport, because like, I don't know, it's all like individual. Like, it's an independent sport, like, most definitely, because it's all based upon how you perform. And like, team sports are cool, but like, I feel like with cross country, it's like I said, it's like it's based upon how you perform.
I miss my teammates the most and the opportunity to run with like all different people and having guys and girls like together on the team. And like this year I got the chance to run with a lot of like the different groups, and so I'll miss like getting to know everyone on the team and spending time with all of them.
When you're all on the line together and you're just like preparing yourself for like 3 miles of hell. It's just like you have a special bond with them. Like you all feel pain together. I don't know, it's just like, it's a feeling that doesn't compare to anything. Like, you all prepared, you all worked really hard for that moment, and you guys are about to set off into like this race.
I'm gonna miss him, I'm gonna miss Micah, and I'm gonna miss the other people on the team, and I'm gonna miss you, and I'm gonna miss the Portland trip, the Arcadia trip, and every other trip that's outside of California. And I'm gonna miss the spaghetti feed. I'm gonna miss the meats.
Oh man. The spaghetti feeds are pretty cool. I'll miss those. I have some memories with some people at the spaghetti feeds. The people, I'll miss you too, coach. I'll miss all the coaches too. But just being around everybody, you know, being in the room, whether we're going over PRs or just watching videos with each other, you know, or just being goofy in general, you know, I'll just miss those times that I've enjoyed over doing this, you know, seasons and seasons and seasons.
The people, like, the people on this team are like nobody I've ever met before. Like, they're so, like, unique and caring and funny, and I just feel like it's like such a different group of people, and I'm really gonna miss it. It's like a little family we created, and I'm just gonna miss it.
This year I didn't want it to end. Like, I wanted to keep going and like the whole team get together, because like I really enjoyed this year cross country, so like I'm definitely gonna miss the team.
Friends and like just like spaghetti feeds. Oh my gosh, I want to miss spaghetti feeds so much.
I'm gonna miss the teammates the most, and seeing and laughing with them every single day really brightened my day.
I'd like to say thanks to my parents for being there for me and pushing me to be the best I can be. I want to thank you, coach, for always being there as well. Always pushing me, always telling me to do one more lap, one more, you know, mile, repeat, whatever. And I want to thank everyone throughout the 3 years that have made it such a great team to be on.
I want to say thank you to my parents for just always supporting me no matter what, through injury, through success, through disappointment, just always being a solid rock I can count on.
They didn't always understand this cross-country journey, which I totally understand. I mean, who runs for fun?
Me too.
True stuff. And I'm glad my mom comes out to my races and takes the time to just understand it. Understand that this is my life. You know, she kind of joined in and was like, okay, you love this, I love it too. You know, I know it's not easy to chase around someone going to meets, wanting a new shirt, and you know. It's kind of overkill.
I love you, Mom, and other Mom. Thanks for always being there. Besides when you had to work.
Love you, Dad. Thanks for always pushing me and just being there for me whenever I have bad races. And being my biggest fan when I have my best.
I want to, you know, thank them for the time that they've gave me, helping me, taking me to practice, and being there for me when I need them the most.
Mom and Dad, I wanted to say thanks for always being there for me and coming to my meets and supporting me, but not only at the meets, like even like through my injuries and stuff, like it was like really hard for me, and like you guys were always there like supporting me, like helping me get better and being there if I needed someone to talk to through the good and the bad. And I know I don't say this enough, but I really do appreciate that all you do for me, and it means a lot to me.
Thank you for always being there to support me and being there after my races to encourage me no matter how I did, and always coming out to races to cheer me on.
Hi, Mom. Hi, Dad. Thank you so much for the
unconditional love and support for the last 4 years, both in cross country and in school. Really appreciate you guys supporting me through everything. Even when I yell at you guys never stop loving me, and I really appreciate that.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for like your support and like buying me running shoes every year and stuff.
Thank you, Mom and Dad, for coming to all of my meets and driving me and being so supportive ever since freshman year. It really like makes my day when you guys come, and especially you, Dad. You yell really loud and I can hear you anywhere on the course, and yeah. And shout out to my sister, she comes sometimes.
I definitely thank my mom for having me try out for the sport, and then all my family for supporting me along the way.
But me, Lauren, and Julia were running at Los Vaqueros, and we were coming down the hill like really fast, and like three cows, like I'm not even lying, three cows just like charged like straight at us, like head on. We were so scared, we had to like stop, and we like had to like turn around and like walk away, but they were still staring at us, and yeah, it was pretty crazy.
Oh, at Contra Loma, for I think we were going against Antioch, or I think it was Antioch, and they were saying, because we were saying that TJ, or we like to call him Thick Booty Junior, we were saying the same, we were saying, he's slick, he's quick, but most importantly, he's thick. And that was like, I think that's my favorite memory like this year, which is so
okay.
Fun.
So when we were in Portland, we had a pretty interesting night. The four of us roomed together, and so we all had to shower that night. So Maddie showered first.
So I went in the shower, and I shaved my legs because we had a race the next day. And then I like looked down, but I didn't really have my glasses on, so like I couldn't really see. And it looked like there was like brown stuff in the tub, so I just like, but like I thought, because sometimes when your feet are dirty and then like you put them on the tub, it like
dirty
makes me, I don't know. And then I was, so I just washed it out, and I like thought it was just me, and it was fine.
So then I went and showered, and nothing was wrong except that like the water like wasn't draining right. So I was like, okay, whatever, it'll drain. So I got out of the shower, and then I go in the shower, and there's still water there and stuff, but I was just like, whatever, you know, I don't know. And then I go in, and there's like brown stuff in the corner, and I was like, what's in my mouth? Like, come on now. And then I had to shave, so I was shaving my legs, you know, and I dropped my shaver in the brown stuff. And I was like, oh, like I still gotta shave. So then I rinse it off real quick, and I like get out the shower and I, you know, move on with my life. I didn't know what it was, but I was like, whatever.
Yeah, and so everyone's acting fine, like the shower's fine. And I walk in the bathroom and I look this up, and there's this nasty brown stuff all over the bathroom floor. And I walk outside, I'm like, guys, what did you do in the shower? Because it is nasty in there, and I couldn't shower in there.
And she's like, Alyssa, what'd you do? I was like, what? That was Maya.
And then I was like, so she was just gonna think it was me all day?
It was like chunky brown too.
And then no, you go. And then so we call Becky Bukowski.
Hey, Becky.
And then
there you go.
And then we're telling her the story, right? And she's like, oh, I think it's just something from the shower drain. And we're like, oh,
no. Okay. Like all the other people's old skin had like risen.
And then Alyssa dropped her razor in it and then kept shaving. Maddie thought it was my leg hair.
And we were like, all thought Alyssa was gonna die.
I was crying.
It was just like really long. I don't know.
Well, that's our story. Oh, so shout out Becky real quick.
Good things to eat. What about nutrition? You guys know anything about
spaghetti.
Nutrition?
Spaghetti. I always eat spaghetti.
Bread.
Carrots. Apples. Ranch. Don't forget some grapes.
Celery.
Don't eat too many race day muffins, because that's what that got me a couple times.
Yep. That's right.
Your parting words? Any inspirational quotes for the team?
Togo's is a no-go.
Oh, no. I want pizza!
I got a passion in my pants, and I ain't afraid to show it, show it, show it, show it.
I'm sexy and I know it.
Oh yeah. Right now we're
fall.